Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. My name is Samiza. Of course, as always, we will start today's video with the list of supplies that I'm gonna be using in this month's setup. My theme for this month is mushroom. I don't have any explanation as to why I choose this theme specifically, but I just knew at that time that my color palette for this month will be very earthy, warm colors, and since I never done mushroom before, I thought it's gonna be a good time for me to finally do it, especially since it's fall for most part of the world. So to draw these mushrooms, I first sketch them with my pencil, but you can always just go directly with your brush pens or any pens that you prefer. But for these mushrooms, I am using the Crayola Super Tips in this brick red shade. I also added the simple fall leaves around the mushrooms by using the Crayola Super Tips in the color of light beige. And as you guys can see, I am using outline drawing system in the size of 0.05 to sort of outline the mushrooms, leaving some space in between the color and also the lines, if you get what I mean. But this is totally optional. I feel like this style makes the mushrooms look more cute, but if you like, you can always color in all the way. I personally like to make sure that all my themes are looking minimal and fits my style in general. So after I'm done with the doodles, I took my Staedtler fineliner in the size of 1.0. This is actually thicker than what I usually go for, but this one is only for the borders. And after I'm done with that, I just went ahead and write down the mini calendar and also the header for this cover page. I also used Tombow Dual Brush Pen in code N95 to give the mushroom some shadows to kind of make them pop a little bit. And I also used the same Tombow Dual Brush Pen and my black brush pen to kind of just randomly add the little dots around the cover page to make sure that the entire cover page doesn't look so simple. To finish off the whole decoration, I am using Pentel Extra Point Correction Pen to add the details on the mushrooms, and that basically it for my cover page this month. Moving on to the next page, of course, this is my quote page. So for this page, I decided to draw these mushrooms at the center of the page. And again, I start off with my pencil first to make sure that I don't mess up with the placement and everything. And after I am happy with that, I just went ahead and colored in the mushrooms with the same style I did in my cover page and honestly, the rest of this month's setup. I also decided to use the same Crayola that I used for the leaves to kind of just draw dry grass in between these mushrooms. And this was actually impromptu, like I didn't plan to do it this way at first, but it turned out actually better than my original plan, so that I can't complain. But anyway, to finish off the whole spread, I draw another set of leaves in the corners of this page and kind of just give it a border by using the same fineliner in size 1.0. For the quote, I am using the Artline Drawing System. This one is my favorite go-to when it comes to fineliner, which is in the size of 0.2. So basically for this month's setup, I am using 3 different fineliners, which are the 0.05 to outline the doodles, the mushroom and the leaves to create boxes, and also to write down the numbers in my mini calendars. The 0.2 fineliner, which is for the quotes and headers, and also 1.0, which I only use for the borders. Moving on to the next page, this is my monthly log. So for this month, I bring back the 2-page monthly log layout to my bullet journal. I think I haven't done this for a few months already, but this one is actually smaller compared to the usual layouts that I've done in the past. The size of these boxes is 3x3 grids. After I am done drawing these boxes, I just went ahead and write down the days at the top of the boxes, and I highlight these days by using the same Tombow dual brush pen that I used to make shadows for the mushrooms. So since I have some empty space in the upper part of the page, I decided to add another mini calendar. And as I mentioned just now, I am using the Artline drawing system in the size of 0.05 to write down all the numbers. As you guys will see in a bit, I added a couple more mushrooms in the bottom part of the monthly log. So this explains why I didn't complete drawing the last box. For the empty space in the left hand side of the page, I decided to add my to-do list, and also the space underneath it is for Little Gift Studio, which is my online shop. And for those of you who didn't know, shameless plug here, but I do sell customized drawings and frames, customized keychains, for now only in Malaysia. I still haven't figured out ways of shipping them internationally and economically. So for those of you who ask whether I provide international shipping, unfortunately I don't at the moment. But untuk orang Malaysia, if you guys want to support me and buy my products, you can do so by ordering directly via Shopee, or you can also DM me if you prefer. I have a lot more stuff that I plan to launch very, very soon. But for now, let's go back to this video. Once I'm done drawing and coloring in the mushrooms, I just went ahead and added the details by using the same Pentel Extra Fine Point Correction Pen. I mainly use this pen to fix small mistakes in my bullet journal. In case you guys haven't watched it already, I have one whole video regarding this topic. So if you guys are interested, I already linked the video in my description box down below. Moving on to the next page, this is my habit tracker page. So for this tracker, since November has 30 days, I draw these boxes in size 15x2 grids for the days we have for this month. And after I'm done with that, I just went ahead and write down the dates for each box. After that, I just went ahead and write down the habits that I want to track this month. And by using the same gray Tombow dual brush pen that I used in the previous pages, I just went ahead and highlight the habits. I also decided to decorate the empty space we have in the left hand side of the page with more mushrooms and more fall leaves. This time around, the placement is just random compared to my monthly log, and I think it's safe to say that it's kind of similar with my cover page, except that this one is only on one side of the page. I finish off the whole decoration by adding the outline and the details, which is in the same style I did in my previous pages. The next page is my mood tracker page. Now, this is a new layout that I bring to my bullet journal this month. I first saw it on Instagram, I think from Tian Bujo, if I'm not mistaken. But for the mood tracker, we will draw like a big calendar, and the size for each day is 3x4 grids. If you guys seen my previous plan with me video, I didn't include mood tracker last month because I decided to have a simpler setup last month. But after I saw Tian Bujo's October mood tracker, I know I have to give it a shot. So for this mood tracker, I haven't really decided like what kind of doodle I will draw for the respective mood. Maybe I will just draw like different kind of mushrooms and color them in according to the legend. I don't know yet, but I will definitely share with you guys as we progress through the month. Once I'm done drawing the table and writing down the dates, I just went ahead and doodle a couple more mushrooms beside the header. And for the header, I am using the same header style as I did throughout this month's setup, which is this modern calligraphy style. The next and also the last spread we have in this setup is of course my weekly spread. So for this spread, I first draw 7 boxes for the days we have this week, and the size for each box is 11 times 14 grids. As you guys can see, the placement of these boxes is actually quite random, but the size of each box is still the same, which is, as I said, it is 11 times 14 grids. I personally really like to try out new layouts, and this is actually one of those that I never done in my bullet journal so far. So I thought with the new month, it is actually a perfect time for me to do it. But honestly though, if you wanna like try something new in your bullet journal, or if you wanna add new spreads, new trackers, you don't really have to wait for new month or new year to do it. I honestly always add new spreads throughout the month if I feel like they are necessary for me. So that explains why sometimes you see some specific spreads that I posted on my Instagram that were not in my original plan with me. So back to this video, I just fill in the empty space in between these boxes with more mushroom doodles, and as you guys can see, I draw them in like two styles. One is the random placement style, just like how I did in my cover page, and the other one is where I have them like standing on the ground or on the dry grass, just like the quote page. Once that's done, I just finish off the whole decoration by adding more details for the mushrooms and also the little dots to make sure that it doesn't look too empty. I finish off this weekly spread by writing down the days of the week, of course, and also added the dates. So here's the final flip through of this month's setup. Frankly speaking, I'm quite happy with how this theme turned out. I actually had creative block a few days back. I couldn't decide my theme, like whatever I planned or imagined in my head didn't turn out the way I want them to. But I'm glad I pulled through in the end, and I gotta say, this is by far one of my favorite that I've done so far, because I think it's still simple and minimal, of course, and it's aesthetically pleasing to the eye. Alright guys, I think that's all for today's video. Let me know if you guys have any questions in the comment section down below. Before I end this video, don't forget to give this video a thumb up if you like it. And as I always say, I would really appreciate it if you guys can help me grow my channel by subscribing. I will definitely talk to you guys again, hopefully in the next video. Until then, bye bye.